Hey everyone, in this example video, we're asked to approximate the following definite integral from minus 1 to 1 using Simpson's 1/3 rule with 4 subintervals. Let's just recall what Simpson's 1/3 rule is. This technique is used to approximate definite integrals using numerical methods. In the past video, we talked about the following formula that is the Simpson's 1/3 rule. This is done by generating a series of parabolas that approximate our curve of interest and simplifying. We then choose a step size, which is a trade-off, as smaller step sizes will give us more accurate solutions at the cost of more work or computation time. Now, let's get into solving this equation. The first thing we are going to do is graph our function. The equation we are given looks something like this. Recall from earlier math classes, if we don't know what the function looks like, you can either just plug in a bunch of inputs and plot their outputs, or use some graphing software if it's available to you. Let's now calculate our step size. We know that we want 4 equally spaced intervals. Therefore, we are going to have step sizes of b minus a over n, which is our upper bound 1 minus our lower bound minus 1 over 4, which gives us a step size of 0.5. Let's add these divisions to our graph now. Let's make a small table of input to output pairs that we need to find. Beginning at our lower bound, minus 1, let's work out all the points that we need to find, so adding our step size every time. Then, let's take a minute and plug in all of these inputs to our initial function and evaluate their outputs. As you can see, I have also labeled all of our input-output pairs to make the next step easier. Next, all we have to do is take our equation here and plug in our y values that we just found. Just note that when you're writing out Simpson's 1/3 rule, our first and last variables have 1 coefficients, whereas all the middle ones will have a 4, 2, 4, 2 repeating pattern. If you're wondering why, check out the theory video linked in the description down below. Let's plug in all our values and simplify. This results in our approximating definite integral of 7.333. But how close is this to the actual answer? Well, because we began with a simple polynomial, this is actually very easy to calculate. Using the sum rule for integrals, we can actually break our integral apart into its components, making finding a solution extremely easy. Then, using the exponent rule and the multiplication of constant rule, we can just go ahead and solve these couple simple definite integrals. We can then go ahead and solve the definite integrals, and this leaves us with 22 over 3, which is 7.33, the exact answer as earlier. But why is this? We said that we were only approximating our solution. How do we end up getting the exact solution? When using the Simpson's 1/3 rule on a polynomial of third order or lower, we actually get the exact solution, and not just an approximation, which is cool and a useful thing to know. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how you can solve an example of approximating a definite integral using Simpson's 1/3 rule. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.